As the table turns, so goes the soundtrack of our lives.
Hey VC, this is Carlos from As the Table Turns. I wanted to come on here and do a video. I got a box in from Blue Note Records, so that's exciting. And here we go. Yeah. All right. Probably spent a little too much money, but I got some Tone Poets and some 80's. And I ordered these a while ago, and everything was kind of held up because two of the records were pre-orders, and so they didn't ship until the beginning of November, but mine took a while getting here. I don't know. Everybody seemed to get theirs like 2 weeks ago. But anyway, first record is Duke Pearson. I haven't taken them out yet, but I have listened to them on Spotify. Just to kind of talk about them a little bit. But Duke Pearson, The Phantom. And yeah, so this one is, it's a little weird because it's, it starts out with this really moody song, but then goes into this, I don't know, goes for a couple songs, goes into this kind of loungy type feel, and then it goes into this kind of, the first song is very loungy, or the second song is very loungy, then the third song is kind of, almost kind of this loungy, going on a trip type feel, and then maybe that's what it is. Maybe it's going on a trip, like the experience is going on a trip or something, I don't know. But then there's these Latin songs in there, these two with Latin influences, and then there is a kind of a bluesy, more of a somber bluesy ballad, like second to last song. And then it goes back to, I think, to a kind of a more of a Latin feel. So it's kind of a little bit all over the place, I think. I don't know. So possibly why this one isn't as one of his more popular ones, but it doesn't just seem like a cohesive album all the way. But it's really good. You know, I like all the different songs by themselves. They're great. It just feels like the album isn't very cohesive. But that's just me. That's my opinion. But you have Jerry Dagian on flute and alto flute, Duke Pearson on piano. Sorry for the glare. Sam Brown on guitar, Al Goff on guitar, Bob Crenshaw on bass, Mickey Roker on drums, Victor Pentojo on conga, and Potato Valdez on conga and cuero. Cuero? Cuero? I don't know how to say that. Anyway, next we have, and the thing is, on this one you have Bobby Hutcherson on vibes, which definitely, you know, gives it that loungy feel for those second and third songs. But on here you have, this is Bobby Hutcherson, the kicker. You have Duke Pearson on this one playing piano, so it's kind of like they swapped. But you have Joe Henderson on tenor sax, Bobby Hutcherson on vibes, of course, Grant Green on guitar, Duke Pearson on piano, Bob Crenshaw on bass, and Al Harewood on drums. So this one feels like a very cohesive album. I love this one. I think this tops The Phantom, you know, as far as a Duke Pearson, Bobby Hutcherson swap or... But anyway, I really like this album. This is great. Mirrors is a very kind of quiet, subdued. when I listened to it on the Spotify, it had one more song, one more track to it. So must just be on the what do you want to call it? Extended CD and digital versions of this. So anyway, it starts out with Mirrors, I guess, which on the other one, when I listened to it on Spotify, it was the second track. But Mirrors is a ballad for Duke. Kind of a cool song. The Kicker definitely is. The Kicker and Step Lightly are very, or no wait, maybe it's for Duke and then The Kicker. They're very high tempo songs or higher tempo songs. But anyway, The Kicker, really, really awesome. Love Bobby Hutcherson on the vibes. He's just great. This one I haven't listened to a whole lot, but, you know, definitely gotten a feel for it. And, you know, it's Jackie McLean, you know, going to the edge of everything. You know, just enough that it's not, I can still listen to it and still enjoy it. But yeah, Jackie McLean, It's Time. You got Charles Tolliver on trumpet, Jackie McLean on alto sax, Herbie Hancock on piano, Cecil McBee on bass, and Roy Haynes on the drums. Cancellation, just the first song, just coming off of it, just as great. I think you have trumpet and bass kind of dueling a little bit, or like hit. It's either he's playing over himself, or it's the trumpet and the sax, which I think it is, playing at the same time, kind of dueling. It's pretty cool. But yeah, definitely a cool album. Like I said, he's just kind of taking it to the next level, and I think that's kind of what it means. It's time, you know, it's time for that to happen. It's time to let it loose, you know. This, on the other hand, is very much the other side of Blue Note, in it being very soul jazz type. Rather than trying to get out there and get on the edge of everything, it's staying in the pocket, staying in that groove, staying in that rhythm. You got Stanley Turrentine on tenor sax, Shirley Scott, his wife, on the organ, Kenny Burrell on guitar, Bob Cranshaw on bass, and Otis Finch on the drums. This is just a very soulful, which I love, you know. And that's kind of the thing, is I think people kind of go back and forth, or they pendulum swing from one to the next. And I like both of them. I like to go from one to the next. You know, going from this to then this, you know, building up to it, right? This is a very solid album. Love this one. It might be my favorite. I don't know. There's another Stanley Turrentine. I'm forgetting the name of it right now. It's his face. It's a lot bigger. It's blue. Him kind of smiling. I have that, or I'm gonna be probably getting that one for Christmas. It's right here. That's where it's at. It's that one right there. So that one or this one, you know, very in the same kind of vein, very blues driven, soul jazz. Awesome album. In that same vein, you have my first Jimmy Smith. So I'm glad to have this Prayer Meeting, Jimmy Smith with Stanley Turrentine. Just kind of in that same vein of with him and Shirley Scott, him and his wife. You have now Jimmy Smith and Stanley Turrentine. Definitely want to pick up some more Jimmy Smith, but this is a great start. I think the Classic Series is going to be issuing the incredible Jimmy Smith back at the Chicken Shack. But there's some other ones. I think all these ones back on the back here that I really want to grab. This one right here. What's that one called? I don't know about the Waller one. Plays Waller. But the Sermon I definitely want to get, and House Party I definitely want to get. Home Cooking, definitely want to get that one too. But yeah. All right, so this one is the one that I'm gonna have to kind of get used to. I picked it up, you know, just listening to it and going, kind of trying to concentrate on what was happening in it. And it's Andrew Hill, Smokestack. This one's definitely out there. It's more out there than I would say It's Time. So this one I'm gonna have to get used to, listening to, but I'm glad I have it, you know. And you know, that's what this is all about. It's kind of, you know, growing your taste and understanding what these guys are trying to put out, you know, and what they're trying to do musically. So glad I have that. On this one you have Andrew Hill piano, Richard Davis bass, Eddie Kahn bass, and Roy Haynes on drums. So you got the two bassists on here. So this starts the 80s with that one. Then I got the Judah Hip, which I kind of didn't know about her at all, but she was born in, from getting what country right now, but she eventually got discovered and moved to the U.S. This is her with Zoot Sims. I was actually trying to, last night, trying to research. I really want to get the one with her and Lars Gullin. I love Lars Gullin. I haven't really been able to find him, but he's a Swedish baritone sax player. So really want to pick up some of his stuff. And she has one with him. But this is just great. This is kind of just right down the line, jazz. Just kind of great middle of the road type jazz. Middle of the road, maybe a bad term. I'm not trying to say it's boring or anything like that. It's not boring, but it's not way out there like an Andrew Hill or even a Jackie McLean. It's Time. It's just kind of just right down the line of what Blue Note normally does, right? So, but this has Jerry Lloyd on trumpet, Zoot Sims on tenor sax, Judah Hip on piano, Ahmed Abdul Malik on bass, Ed Thigpen on drums. So, and then I was able to pick this one up as well. Freddie Hubbard, Open Sesame. I love this Freddie Hubbard. This might be my favorite Freddie Hubbard. It has Freddie Hubbard on trumpet, Tina Brooks on tenor sax, McCoy Tyner on piano, Sam Jones on bass, and Clifford Jarvis on drums. Just a really solid album. Like, love Clifford's playing in this. Love Tina Brooks is playing in this. Love McCoy Tyner's playing in this. It's just all around such, the compositions, the music choices, or the song selections are great. All throughout, I think it's a very cohesive album, just like I was saying about the other. So I really like this one. The soul jazz vein, one of the people that kind of definitely went off and in that direction, a clear direction towards that all the way, was Lou Donaldson. And this is definitely one of the albums that put him on that map of soul jazz, Alligator Boogaloo. This has Melvin Lasty Sr. on cornet, Lou Donaldson on alto sax, George Benson on the guitar, Lonnie Smith on organ, and Leo Morris on the drums. But yeah, just really love this. Very soul jazz, kind of that 60s vibe. That 60s movie vibe. Don't want to say Austin Powers, but kind of down that vein of kind of the 60s movie. Anyway. This guy, besides what his playing with Eddie Lockjaw Davis, no one really talks about him very much, and it's Johnny Griffin. Introducing Johnny Griffin. That's weird. It's called Introducing Johnny Griffin here, and on the back it's called Chicago Calling. So I don't know what that is. That's weird. Anyway, Johnny Griffin on tenor sax, Wynton Kelly on piano, Curly Russell on bass, and Max Roach on drums. That's quite a quartet. That's a pretty solid quartet. But Johnny Griffin shreds. You know, he blazes through these songs. It's a Clifford Brown type tempo. It's a Freddie Hubbard type tempo. The way he's playing, he is just kind of flying through these things. The speed at which he plays is just astonishing. So, Johnny Griffin, look that one up. To go along with some more of my Dexter Gordon, I got Doing All Right. This was the first album that Dexter Gordon returned with after his prison sentence. After he got out of jail, he returned to Blue Note, or he went to Blue Note, and this was his first album. I'm pretty sure this is his first album that he returned with. Just some great stuff. He basically had to not relearn, but learn what hard bop, you know, what was the sound, the hard bop sound that was happening at the time. He had to learn from the people that learned from him, come back and made some great albums for Blue Note, and then went overseas and still made great albums for Blue Note. But Dexter Gordon, that's an awesome album. And then we got Grant Green, Grant's First Stand. So you got Grant Green on guitar, Babyface Willette on organ, and Ben Dixon on drums. This is just a trio. Awesome album. Really love these early Grant Greens. I think there's only one or two prior to this, for Blue Note at least. Love this one. I don't know if I showed this. This is what we're listening to right now in the background. But this is Stanley Turrentine, Coming Your Way. Stanley Turrentine on trumpet, Stanley Turrentine on tenor sax, Horless Parliament on piano, George Tucker on bass, and Al Harewood on drums. It's still bluesy, but it's not as bluesy as the other Stanley Turrentines. I think it's, or not as soul jazzy, I would say, maybe, as the others. This is just kind of blues, blues-based. It's great. Oh, love it. Show the inside here. Sorry for the glare. But that's the inside. There's the back. I love these covers, man. They're so nice. So that is my unboxing for my Blue Note that came in. And I hope you enjoyed it. Please subscribe. Give me a like. Comment below if you have any questions or comments on more information on each of these albums or the people in them. I will see you later, VC. Bye.